Is that the summer over with? Sure looks that way, doesn't it? Or will it brighten up when the kids go back to school? Who knows? Anyway, see you in a minute. I'll show you what's been going on down the allotment. See you in a moment. What is she doing?
What are you doing?
She's getting the cabbages out.
It's a bloody mess up here. Look at it. It's disgusting. I can't be here. I can't die in peace, can I?
See, she's been here a couple of weeks. It's been left for me to do. I think I've done well. I've done the quick thing to do. See? I covered it all. Covered it all. That's the way to get rid of weeds. Yes. Cucumbers, not been doing too bad. We've had quite a few off of here already. Lots of your mini munches and your lemon crystals. Peppers are coming on lovely. Got some big peppers there, but they're not ripe until they go red. Never buy a green one. And these things, well, I don't know what colour these are supposed to go. All these, are they supposed to go black? Let us know in the comments. I know there go, these go red because I've had some red ones off of there. But these, what's that? What's going on? Are they ripe? Are they ready? I don't know. I don't fancy taking my name in been admitted to hospital with burns and blisters to the mouth. But celery. Celery's looking good. We've had quite a bit of wind over the weekend. And also noticed that the neighbours' runners have completely snapped. All their poles have snapped and they're away for the week now. We did rescue an apple tree up there. I'll show you that later on, what we've done to that. But the pumpkin, it's just the one now. What's this? This is spinach, I believe. It's just food for the deer at the minute. And same with the, I did have the name of it. But yeah, same with the deer. Deer loves that. We've been eating some parsnips, which have been lovely. They've been coming out nice. The lettuce is coming on. And my carrots. They're looking really good at the moment. And we've been getting quite a few runner beans.
Yeah.
It's a big one here, Kim. Did you not want to take this one?
Oh, I didn't see that one.
Oh, she didn't see that one. She didn't see that one.
I was just thinking.
Was it not long enough for you?
Somebody's stealing them.
She thinks someone's up here stealing our runners, which I've told her, don't be daft.
Because we only got as many as I thought we would.
Don't be daft. Mind you, we are fighting against the deer at the minute. Everything's sort of lower down.
The pear tree's becoming a bean tree.
It's just becoming, yeah. As we know for next year, don't plant runner beans
next to a
tree. Because they climb up a tree. Of course, everyone else knows that apart from us. So the poor tree, I mean, we're topping the ends as soon as we find them. But as soon as you top one, another four seems to grow up overnight. Yeah, I've done that one already. So yeah, it can grow higher and go really high. Swede, we've been eating Swede as well. So we've used all that. It's been absolutely gorgeous. So we've got a couple of little ones in there. But I think we'll just pull up a few more. See the likes of that. You know, it's just too small. Well, I don't know. It's a mouthful, isn't it? There's still some quite big Swedes in there, like the one at the back over there. She wants to get the rest of the cabbages up. because what we're going to do is slice that up all this week and make a big coleslaw, which the kids will go mad over. These blackberry bushes we need to tidy on back, because this is a path for everyone to walk up. So I think it's our responsibilities to stop people that walk up this way. Stop them getting pricked and stung. Whereas they won't on our ones, because our ones haven't got the spikes on them, our blackberry bushes. But the gentleman's this side, who doesn't seem to be doing anything with this allotment, it's just all gone out of control. So we're cutting it back, slicing it all back, which I have to do in a minute. Looks like we've got a... Yeah, that's coming right out. Oh, it's just never ending. You just can't leave it for a week. So Seneca's Kim's been quite poorly that I've been sort of looking after her. So yeah. So we're back up here now. She's back on her feet. Feels she can do a bit more. Being a pain in the bum, that's what she's been. Same with our neighbour's rhubarb here, look at that. Look at it. God, I want to chop all that up as well. Just cut through it. But yeah, you can obviously see the wind's knocked all over his tomato plants as well. I would try and pick them up, but the sticks have snapped, and I've not got no spare sticks for him. But we noticed that the weekend, so he's not been obviously up here for a while. So, what's that? Right, let's go and show my favourite place, which is my greenhouse. And as you can see, there's not much left on big balls. That's because we've picked some real big ones, and Kim's made some lovely big bowls of goulash, and we've frozen it all up. She used no tomato juice, no tomato puree, it was just pure tomatoes. She's used the rest of them again today to do a lasagna. And she's used up all the tomatoes in the house. And I said, don't worry, there's bound to be a few more tomatoes in the greenhouse. Yeah, just a few. Just a few. Yeah, everywhere. And as for the cucumbers, I mean, crikey. Well, I know for next year, don't I, eh? I know for next year. Possibly only the one cucumber plant. Right, so I'm going to just do a quick harvest of the tomatoes and the cucumbers. And I'll see you in a minute. I'll tell you what, I don't know about a cucumber shop. I'm going to have to open up a bloody tomato shop. Anyway, not a bad little harvest for today. Again, loads of cherry tomatoes and some, we got the, oh my word, tomatoes are tomatoes, surely. Well, they go, I'll get the names in a minute. They'll be up on screen, I'm sure they will. So, yeah, that'll keep us going. I'm not going to, pick the cucumbers, because even though they're quite big, I'm going to let them grow a bit larger, because it's going to stay firmer a lot longer. And if we're taking them home, you know, even though they're a good 2 foot long, they're soft, they start getting soft after about 2-3 days. So I'd rather be in there, because at least they're still growing, than at home, because we've still got 3 cucumbers at home. Like I said, the wife's picked all the rest of the cabbages, and quite a few of them are quite rotten, so we cut them up the best we can. Again, loads more on the beans and some onions. That's for another goulash she's going to make. So it'll be nice. Let's pick up our stick. Right. Let's show you what I've been doing. Here we go. We can actually walk down the path now. Without being attacked by blackberry bush and stinging nettles. So that's nice. Even though it's not my bush. But I want to try and get hold of that allotment. So when I see the gentleman next, because he owns the one on the end of this one. And he only took this one on this year. And I think it's become a little bit too much for him. So I'm going to ask if you don't mind me taking it over and then see if I can get onto the council, get it transferred across, which would be good. Because then what I'll do is we'll cut most of this away, probably half of it. Because I think we've got some raspberries down here. I'd rather keep the raspberries because when we've got blackberries, but keep a few blackberries on the end. Find where the raspberry bush is around about here. And then cut all this through to make a big pathway. So we'd have an L-shaped allotment then. That will be the project. That'd be a project. So get back to digging again and digging out the beds and planning for next year and growing that that exotic stuff that someone mentioned. The experimental food. That'd be good because that one's in the sunshine all day. That one there. We've also got a lovely pear tree down there, and plum trees. Big plum tree there, which would be nice. Right, that's about it, isn't it? Everything's locked. It's put away. Lovely. And let's go home. Right, until next time. Bye-bye.